Yeah, 21, the biggest. Put a nigga in the chicken wing, pussy.
21, can you do something for me?
21.
Can you hit a little rich flex for me?
21.
Then 21, can you do something for me?
21.
Drop some bars to my pussy ex for me. Then 21, can you do something for me? Can you talk to the ops next for me?
Okay.
21, do your thing. 21, do your thing.
Do your thing. Welcome. You are tuned in now to the EPB podcast. As usual, it's your boy Matt Marshall, joined by the unmistakable George Blamo. And we have a OG, triple OG,
yes,
back in the studio, finally.
We bike.
Boy, Jared Jeezy.
You back, baby.
What's up, bro? Welcome back. I know you're feeling good.
Mr. Arsenal.
Mr. Arsenal is back. I told you we get our Arsenal back in the studio. I know you're excited. He's got a lot of shit to talk, but before we get to that, obviously, we playing that new Drake 21. I just want a quick yes, yay or nay. It's just a old Spartan thumbs up or thumbs down on the album so far, what you've listened to. It's been out for, a couple days?
Yay for sure for me. 100%.
Why are you looking at me like that?
I'm just saying, if you say no, it don't matter because 97 million people listen to
97
it.
97 million streams
in one day.
In a day. It don't matter what your thoughts are.
It don't matter what your thoughts are.
It don't matter. They on.
They got that bread.
They bread it.
My bad. Universal got that bread.
No. So they both license their music to Universal or whoever. So they actually own their own shit.
But yes, but they Universal gave them an advance.
Drake's, yeah.
So until they make that back,
so
it's going to Universal.
If Drake makes that $430 million, then it's 50-50 after that.
Ooh.
It's a 360 deal.
So Drake gave up a piece of his masters for that, though. So he doesn't owe them anything. Like, they're working.
Oh, they're just taking that money from that. But
technically,
it's better to own the masters, no?
Majority of advances never get paid back.
That's true, but when you're Drake, I don't have an advance because I don't need you to
97 million streams in a day. I don't need your money, bro.
I don't.
Just give me
need,
my distro and
again, yeah, yeah.
Take what you need. I got the rest.
Yeah, yeah. So,
but we were talking about that too. Only Drake can do that.
Totally.
Like in the music
and the
industry,
Weeknd.
That and yeah, and well, yeah, obviously.
And Bad Bunny.
You go pop,
so those three
and
can,
Bad Bunny,
can do it.
But yeah, and like Ariana Grande and Taylor Swift and. No, really, not even. No.
Taylor is smart. She owned all her things.
Taylor, I know.
Well,
Taylor
now because Clear Brown. Yeah.
But I'm talking Ariana, nah.
No.
Really?
No way.
Okay.
No.
What's that, Sony? I don't know even what's going on with that.
It's not hers. Let's just put it like that.
Yeah. Yikes. Well, music lessons coming with Jared and motherfucking George soon because that industry is a no-no for me. But before we get into anything, as we see to my left, LAFC MLS champs. It's okay, George. We know you don't watch MLS. You don't have to even comment.
I'm just saying,
on
New
this.
York won last year, so I moved
Did
here.
They? I
you moved here. You brought the energy, whatever. We out here. Did New York win last year? NYCFC?
Of course.
I missed that.
Yeah, we all missed that.
We all missed that.
That's what I'm saying.
But we didn't miss this one.
No.
And if you did, you got go on Fox Sports right now and replay it because that was probably one of the littest MLS. It's definitely MLS Cups games I've seen,
sure.
Let alone final.
Yeah, for sure.
But might be one of the littest MLS games
ever.
I've seen, you know?
I agree.
And it wasn't because it was all great. Look at this man sleeping on everything. It wasn't because it was great soccer necessarily, but it was good enough soccer with great names and the actual drama of the game. Two 120th minute overtime goals to send it to PKs and then a wild back and forth PK. Like,
wild.
What else you need? Yeah, I mean, wild in the fact that there was poor shooting and some great saves.
Well, I mean, like, you asked for that kind of final. You want scoring, you want drama,
goals,
you want all
drama.
That. And it had that. I mean, yeah,
and
so.
It was lit, Bank of California.
So what's funny is Matt was saying, like, you have the names. I knew, like, a Gareth Bale and a Vela.
Yes.
So, like, as far as like the names, I was like, okay, maybe
those are big enough names in typical MLS finals.
Yeah,
like
but two names, bro.
What are you
two names? got household names.
You got
names.
Chicho Arancho. You got, I mean, all Who? Of LAFC has got yeah. household Who? Names.
Like,
man,
it's like,
man,
I get what you're saying, but it's like, come on, listen, man.
Like, we're household all soccer names, fans. Bro. We all watch Europe, but like, I'm excited about this. Proves that there's a product here that is worth watching.
I agree.
That's worth selling.
I agree.
That's worth developing.
I agree.
And like, that, it shows. Gareth Bale, like, Gareth Bale is a finals hero
okay.
in many countries.
Okay. So it's funny because I text you before he scored yesterday.
Yes.
And I was like, he's like,
yo, wait a minute. I'm so glad you brought that up. Yo, hold on.
That was crazy.
Yo, you didn't hear this yet.
That
literally,
was crazy.
It was probably, it wasn't even overtime yet. So it was before Gareth scored his goal. And I want to say it was 2 minutes before this man scored his goal.
Right before
let me read to you exactly what this man says to me. Legit. I just told him I screenshot the hell out of this because I'm about to paste this everywhere.
What's that?
Yo, Jared says, bruh, this game is unreal! Exclamation point. For real, it is. You say you hear Paxton Aronson's going to Frankfurt, which another American on his way to Europe. That's dope. Then literally the next thing is, Bale is the literal definition of waste man. Man is a waste youth, and right on cue, this man up like a salmon for that header, dog. That is the funniest text, bro. That's the funniest text.
So why I said that is because he had just come on again in overtime. So
yeah,
again, you're a household name, but you're coming in the 108th.
He got injured though earlier,
whatever.
And they were preserving him for the
always
World Cup.
Hurt. Yeah, he's preserving himself hurt. Forever. And he came on. And he was moving like he was Van Dyke, just pointing around, not doing anything. It's like, bro, you're on the field for a reason. Like, move.
What did you say while you were watching him?
He's chilling.
He's chilling.
He's chilling.
He's big chilling.
He was just chilling.
Mm-hmm.
You blame him?
Do you blame him?
Yeah.
He's like, he's got five Champions
Leagues. Man, look at
him. Gareth Bale has five Champions
Leagues.
Look at
his smile.
And now he has an MLS Cup.
No. This man got gray hair. He's chilling.
And now he's on his way to a World Cup, in fact, and we can talk about this a little more, in which players are dropping out like flies.
Wales is not going to do anything World Cup.
I mean, Wales
I guarantee
is, Wales, it might be Wales US coming out that group.
That's what
for,
I
real, for real,
the,
for real. For real, for real.
Blasphemy. What?
Blasphemy.
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 What's the last thing you've seen England win?
So can we bet?
Ooh.
Wait, hold on. They were in the final of the European Championship.
I said, what did they win?
Doesn't matter. They're
so
just,
can we bet?
Bet what?
Hey, and who did they lose to? Which team who's
Italy.
Going to the World Cup did they lose to?
It was Italy.
Oh, wait. That team ain't in the World Cup.
Sure.
That don't mean shit.
Italy beat everybody else.
I like this.
Yeah, I like this.
Arsenal looking nice.
It's time to put the money where the mouth is.
I think you need a Thomas Partey Saliba jersey.
Oh, we betting jerseys.
You know what's funny is I've been trying to figure out who to put on the back of my jersey, but I've been giving it like a thorough first half of the season thing.
Wales versus England.
You have Wales?
Yes.
I do too.
No. I what about the group?
What do
about
you mean?
The group? No,
I do too.
Who do you have getting out of the group? USA, England? Wales, England. Iran, USA.
Come on.
Yo, don't sleep on
Iran.
Yo, he's been telling me don't sleep on Iran for weeks now. And like,
boy, Taremi's a problem.
This man has one name. That's
slept.
Less household name.
Yeah, I'm trying to say that's not the household name.
Hey,
Taremi, who?
Last thing, Taremi going to score.
Taremi going to maybe make some. But yeah, who you got coming out that group?
Damn.
I know. Is it really that hard, y'all? Like,
well, because the U.S. is just so like flimsy,
topsy-turvy,
dude.
And we don't know if Weston McKennie will even go to the World Cup. Like, you know, yeah.
And your boy Christian is
out of form.
Is even playing.
But Brendan Aaronson and Tyler Adams are in form.
They are starting.
Motherfucking your boy. What's our keeper's name?
Matt Turner.
Done replaced. They done replaced my boy Zach Steffen with the.
But why?
Replace you.
They have this guy Cohen that's been playing in.
For whom?
Some team in UEFA.
For Arsenal? Or
no.
Is he on Arsenal?
No, we have Matt Turner.
They got Matt Turner.
No, there's another one. There's another
American.
Last name is Cohen.
I mean, there's like
there's
two
American
or three
players.
Or four of them out there that are balling right now, per usual. Like
Josh Cohen. Yeah.
Where's he at?
He's at Maccabi Haifa. That's why you've seen him.
Come on,
because he's been taking them L's from
Eminem.
I saw a win against Juve.
Against who?
They just beat Inter today.
Yo.
That's a big win for them.
That's the first.
They beat Inter today. But they're Israeli. What do they play them in?
No, Juve.
Oh, Juve beat Inter
today? Or Juve, right now. Yeah. They're still Juventus.
That means, you know, I think Dzeko and Lukaku are hurt. All that shit. But then, no, I guess that's a big... That don't mean shit to me, bro. And Juve is just on a spiral right now. Like, I can't even... I can't even... I'm hoping Weston McKennie gets healthy and goes somewhere. Go to Chelsea.
I mean... High key, like, he's been balling for them and scoring, like, regularly whenever he's playing.
We talk about Bale scoring clutch goals, and I'm not going to compare. It's a little blaspheme to compare Weston McKennie, but every time Weston McKennie is under the brightest of lights, he be balling. He be scoring goals in the Champions League against teams like PSG and others to name. So, like, yeah, I mean, he'll be a big miss if he misses.
He's certified by Ronaldo.
And he's certified by Ronaldo, for real. Ronaldo fucks with him heavy. And he was the kid on the team at that point.
Who's the best U.S. player right now?
Right now, like the best in form, or who just is the best U.S. player?
The best period right now.
It's between, for me, right. Every time you say right now, it switches. Like
Clint Dempsey.
Ever, for me, that's mine.
That's true.
For sure.
Clint's the GOAT for me, too.
He's still
there. But... I would say right now, Gio Reyna is just such a wild card, bro. He is such at his top, he is hands down that dude for the U.S. I never see him really at his top. I've never seen him at his top for the U.S., I'll say that. I've seen him like on some next level shit at Dortmund for
sure.
Dude,
Gio.
And I've seen him up there for U.S.
Dude, Gio and Aronson should be running wherever they're at. I love Brent Aronson. Like, as a U.S. player, for sure, right now. Because I saw him play for Salzburg, not a lot, but Champions League here and there.
Yeah.
Always balling.
Yeah.
You go check the scoreline. He has a goal or assist somewhere. In Leeds, he's not, like, doing his thing right now but against new league, faster league. But he's keeping up every game.
No, he definitely deserves to play in the Premier League.
Totally.
I'll say that, you know. What, Leeds is 12th right now, you know, whatever. It's a full team. My thing is he's doing very well, and I can see him even starting for the U.S.
Totally.
The issue I have with him is the type of player he is not who I want at the U.S. anymore. We've had millions of hustle guys.
But not as skillful as Aronson.
Yeah, but you heard my first Gio Reyna and Brendan Aronson's skill. You know, discrepancy is it's just different. Like when you see Gio, he looks like a player. Well, when you see Brendan, he looks like a hustle. You know, it's like a hustle player. You know,
maybe he scores though too.
Yeah, he definitely scores.
Tappins though.
He ain't scoring worldies.
Whatever.
When's the last time you've seen him score from outside the box?
Though, I mean, you're still scoring though,
right? And which is why he should score. You need scoring.
Because I was telling George, we don't have a striker that's.
No, we don't have any info.
Doing it. We need to play with a false nine and hope that works out.
We're probably going to play with a false nine. Pulisic is going to be in there, like, mucking stuff up. They're going to have Gio on the left and, you know, whoever on the right, Tim Weah or somebody. I don't know.
Would you consider Salah a hustle player?
I would consider, now that Salah has gotten to the level he's gotten, I would not just classify him. Again, like, if Brendan Aronson was, like, taking players on regularly and scoring, again, worldies outside the box, inside the box, this and that, then it would be, you know, then he would be more than a hustle player. But, like, that Salah is much more than that. Like, we got to, you know, Salah's been top three on Ballon d'Or lists. You can't just, that's not just hustle. I know. I know we roll our eyes at that. But what was the stat you just gave me today about Salah?
He's three goals away from being Liverpool's all-time leading top scorer.
Say what you want about Salah. Say what you want about Mane's impact on Salah and on the team that's clearly being shown.
So,
like, Salah does his thing.
Can you look up the assists from Mane?
Like, how many, like, total assists?
From Mane to Salah.
This man always. Nah, anytime we talk Salah, Mane has to creep in this.
I agree with George.
It has to.
I do not disagree that Mane was a super key part to Salah and Liverpool's success. But
he's there for a reason. Just look up his stats.
Just look at them. Don't try to argue, man.
I mean, it's like I was thinking to myself last year. I was like, if anybody gets let go. Not let go, but like can go for the contract. I would let Salah go, not Mane, 100% of the time.
I agree with 100% you. 100% I agree with you 100% of the time. But to be honest, I do not think Liverpool would be in any much better of a position. What are they like?
They're 16th. Seventh. Think. Oh, no, sorry.
They're down.
They're 10th, but 7 points off Tottenham or something like that at a fourth.
Okay.
Yeah. Are they 10th?
Or
are they?
No, they're even lower. No, they're 8th. I'm sorry.
Sorry. They're 8th.
And they're about...
They're 7 off Tottenham. Just top 4.
Yeah, they're 7 off Tottenham.
Which isn't, again,
it's respectable.
Yeah.
It's not crazy.
No.
But because of Liverpool has been so great, well, I was thinking they were 17th just now in my head. So all I'm saying is, like, I think it's the drop off of all the players who have dropped off thus far. They have not replaced any of the players who've left with anybody who has been better, like that much better.
Yeah.
Like when they brought in Naby Keita and Fabinho and Thiago, none of those have amounted to the
Fabinho
influence.
Definitely has.
The influence Wijnaldum had on the game. Fabinho is hardly ever in the game. He's injured so many times.
Like more recently, but for a long period of time, he was there.
He was there.
He was there.
The only one.
He was, yeah. I mean, yeah. You have Henderson, which,
yeah,
which
Fabinho
which,
and Hendo.
Which, like, I'm starting to get rid of him. I mean, he's just one of these, like, rah, rah, I'm yelling. I have a beard now because I'm an OG. So I'm going to. Fuck Jordan Henderson. He's trash. He's so trash. He's so trash to me.
He's the quota.
Doug, I disrespect this man.
I am.
Disrespecting this man. Quota. This man is playing.
They have to have some English-born players.
Yes, they do. But they also have to have leaders. They also have to have guys who dig it out.
English.
You also like, you are just, y'all saw that interview with Thierry Henry where he's like, man, people don't understand the importance of the simple things in soccer.
Henderson can hit a 40-yard
ball on a running Mo Salah like it is nothing.
So
and we will bring up YouTube.
Trent can do it too.
Yeah, but nobody. He's calling Trent garbage. Well, now they are calling Trent garbage, but bro, Trent's not garbage.
No, he's not. He's 50 years old.
You're telling me that you can't. I can't even. What? I can't even. This whole Henderson hate, bro. No.
Henderson like is Captain not Hendo. Good.
No, he's not good.
He's an average player.
Define good. Is Henderson better than McTominay?
Average.
Is Henderson better than McTominay?
They're the same.
Is Henderson
tier.
Better than Jorginho?
They're the same.
Who?
Jorginho?
Henderson is not better than Jorginho.
I'd rather take Henderson than Jorginho.
Then Wijnaldum?
Then Jorginho. Chelsea's Jorginho.
I would take.
Oh no.
I'd rather take Henderson.
You're what?
Hugging. I'd rather take Henderson.
What?
And that's a Chelsea fan saying.
Oh,
and it's no disrespect
what?
To Jorginho. It is just big ups to Hendo, bro.
That is one of the worst takes ever.
That is so disrespectful.
That's one of the worst takes
I know you don't like Italy,
of all
but that
time.
Is so disrespectful.
That's crazy.
Wow. Are you mad?
There is no world where I would take Jordan Henderson over Jorginho.
Over Jorginho?
There's no...
Over Jorginho.
There's no...
What has Jorginho gotten?
Your Champions League, your Super Cup.
No, he scored some great PKs, but he didn't get us the Champions League nor the Super Cup.
He was controlling the midfield. What are you talking about?
What are you saying?
Maybe he hasn't done it as late.
He didn't even start against any team except for the final. He didn't even play. It was Conte. Conte got hurt. It's Conte, Kovacic. He can't even start on Chelsea on a full healthy Chelsea team. What are you saying? Hendo is Captain Hendo. Whether in Keita, Fabinho, the rest of them niggas are there or not. What are y'all saying? I don't want to hear this blaspheme. Hendo, just listen to me, bro. I got you. I don't even like the Scousers like that, but I got you. We understand.
That's
game recognized game.
That's one of your worst takes ever, honestly. Outside of your Giroud is better than Benzema take. That's your second worst
take
ever.
Wait, what was my take with Giroud?
Stop the cap. I never said Giroud was better than Benzema. I said I would rather have him in France's team than Benzema.
But I did not say
he's better.
No, it's not. Sometimes in football, you don't get the best players
on
a team.
In no way is Olivier Giroud.
Ask PSG what having all the best players in the world gets you. Nothing. You need chemistry.
This year. I can't wait till they win that shit.
They got rid of great players though. They sold Wijnaldum, brought in Vitinha. They sold in a veteran Champions League winner and brought in a kid from Portugal. And that's not because he's better than Wijnaldum. It's because he fits the system. You got to go with what fits.
In no world, at any time. Is Olivier Giroud a better fit in any team over Karim Benzema?
Okay, well, Olivier Giroud has a World Cup.
Like
and Karim
a
17-year-old.
And
he got robbed.
Does not.
He literally got robbed.
No, bro. He's got a chance now.
Fiat?
Fiat and Ferrari.
Y'all Fiat are trying to and pit Ferrari. It's my boy KB Nueve. Don't take anything personally. I love Benzema, you, bro.
This man,
but I'm just saying, like,
he was wilding out talking about Giroud, back, Giroud.
And
Giroud.
Look at you now, Ballon d'Or champion.
A Ballon d'Or.
Yeah. Did I ever? Come on now, I have
five Champions Leagues. Ballon d'Or. Come on, bro.
Man, y'all are killing me.
See, this is why I miss you.
That's crazy to me. Man,
I just want you to know, I can't find no stat. Like, I don't know. Usually ESPN be having these really oblong stats, but I cannot have
most games played in white cleats over a 10-year period.
Most goals scored with shoelaces untied on with their left foot. Messi. Oh, okay. Like, man, what?
Like, duh.
So I don't know how many of Salah's goals are Mane's assist, but it doesn't matter because Salah is on his way to break that record. Mane is on his way to maybe go deeper in Champions League than
and
Liverpool.
Win a German League and possibly win a Champions League too.
I mean, what is winning a Bundesliga?
Nothing right now.
Exactly.
But Champions League though, I mean, they're a strong ass squad.
They're
a strong ass squad.
They are a strong ass club. Let's talk about Champions League. I mean,
Musiala too.
We had our last games of these rounds.
Wait. I'm sorry. Before we get to any of that, we cannot skate over the fact that y'all got scraped today.
Get out of here. First of all, scraped?
Yay.
Scraped for that ricochet goal? That's what you want?
First of all, it wasn't a ricochet. Secondly, we controlled that entire game, dog.
Dog, get
that entire
out of here.
Game.
Y'all controlled that entire first 10 minutes of the game.
That entire game.
And then you probably fell asleep because that shit was boring as hell. And then
you woke up
and saw the little clink-a-dink, ring-a-dink.
I saw a corner that skipped by everybody and was hidden.
Bro,
by
the little ricochet goal Golasso. Y'all scored. Awesome. Golasso, exactly.
1-0.
Exactly.
At the bridge. Arsenal top of the league. So, you know?
Arsenal. Hey, listen.
Top of the league.
I'm gonna give you your flowers. 11 wins. This is more wins so far than the Invincibles got. That's what the stat said.
I mean, it's more wins than I've seen us get.
More wins than y'all had.
I'm saying 11 wins already.
I'm gonna let you get your flowers, especially because we played y'all in preseason. Y'all absolutely dragged us.
Destroyed.
And
you.
I said that's cap. It's preseason. Let's see what happens when it's game time. No, we do have some notable injuries, but I'm not even gonna go there because it's not even worth it.
None of that.
Because Aubameyang got zero touches, and you and I talked about this.
Aubameyang who? Aubameyang what?
That's disappointing. I will say, and it's not for lack of service. Aubameyang was non-existent in that fucking game today.
So we know how to play him because we had him. There's no hold-up play, and you guys have playing a striker, like a center forward. That's not his role.
You can't have Havertz and Aubameyang on the field like that in that capacity. And Havertz has been playing so well that it's tough.
Havertz missed an open chance for actually Aubameyang today. He could have had two
open chances for Aubameyang, where all he had to do was play a good pass across the face of the goal, and Aubameyang had two tap-ins, and it just didn't happen. So there was some service issues, but it's not just that. It's just like the whole it's the whole system right now. Like I'm happy for Graham Potter. He's doing his thing. Every time I watch Chelsea, it doesn't look like there's any kind of system.
It's
like,
dead football,
bro.
It's
what
so dead.
Is that?
It's dead.
What is that shit?
And it sucks because Raheem went there thinking that he's gonna be doing some shit. It's like, bro, like you're just stuck in like a.
I don't know. Nah, I think Raheem's straight. Raheem is
team.
Literally doing exactly what he did for City. Only City was City. Like he's got to. So for us, it's got to be a little bit more Raheem. But for
a lot more Raheem.
City type stuff.
Like,
he's doing
Hazard type shit.
He's scoring goals. He's creating chances. And that's what Raheem does. Like people were expecting some like world beater out of Raheem.
Yeah,
he's never been that. He had Man City on their backs for 1 year because that was just, you know, he was the only one who's the most consistent. Like Pep was going Mahrez, Bernardo, Foden, whoever. But Raheem had it on his back. But yeah, Raheem's always been that way. He's been exciting, creative, but maybe a little lacking in that like final third efficiency, you know what I mean?
I just think when it like in watching both teams, you just because you guys fired your manager, so you kind of start over again, obviously. Because
fire a manager, it's always the first 10 games are great.
Yeah,
like no matter who you bring in, you can bring in a buster.
Yeah,
you know?
But so in watching us play now, like this is the first or last year I saw it too, but it's the first year where we're like, could we have like a structure and identity? and like, and we played this way the entire game.
Yeah.
And that's all I wanted to see. But then it was like, okay, we can play that. We can play that way, but win games as well.
Dig out wins. And that's what I'm giving you your flowers on. The fact that y'all are actually, y'all didn't like go God mode against us. Y'all haven't actually been God mode in the last couple of games. And I was a little worried about you. I mean, seen Jesus scoring goals like that. You ain't like.
I'm not worried about him scoring goals.
Who's gonna do it for y'all?
Whoever.
He keeps the ball alive.
He does keep the ball.
Like, he's able to hold on to the ball with four.
It's crazy how this 5 foot.
So two, strong, man.
160 pounds, like soaking wet, whatever. And like, he ain't Lacazette even, let alone Giroud, Aubameyang, and he's able to hold that ball. Guy, bro, y'all need to put some respect on Giroud's name, too. He is one goal away from beating Thierry Henry's record for France as well while we talking. So I'm just throwing out reality. Is here. I know we all have eye tests, but Giroud passed the eye test.
I mean, I saw Giroud for years at Arsenal. I just don't believe him.
Those were some tough years, though.
Yeah, but he was supposed to be that guy, and it just.
I don't know about never that guy. Really,
no, he was never. He was supposed to be.
Yeah.
Who?
Exactly.
That's like Marcus Rashford. He don't like Marcus Rashford right now, and I get it. Like, he's doing some waste man shit, but that's because everybody's looking at him like he's supposed to be that guy. Like,
you should be by this time. You should be on.
Bruv, he's doing his thing.
He's playing like Mbappe right now.
He's doing his thing, but he doesn't have the skill set of Mbappe.
That's real talk.
He doesn't have Mbappe's skill set.
Yes, he does.
He does though. He's fast, he's strong. I mean,
yeah, he's fast, he's strong. He gets in front, but he's not clinical as Mbappe. He is not. He doesn't have one-on-one opportunities like Mbappe where he can just blow by.
Yeah, he does.
Well, actually, I'm sorry. He does have those, and he beats the man. He beats his man, and then he shoots it.
Beats the goal.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And he like hurts the goalkeeper's wrist because he shoots it right at him.
Yeah, that's true.
Like Mbappe finishes, you know?
That's true.
That's all the difference. Don't forget, Marcus Rashford himself knocked Mbappe out of the Champions League twice. Mbappe and Neymar. Y'all short memories out here.
I remember, but I'm just saying. Nah.
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 I'm just saying, you got to give, like, again, coaching, team chemistry, system, all that stuff is important.
He's had more than enough time.
He's had at least 6-7 years.
But what are you expecting him to do? Like, if Ronaldo is that dude, scores 24 goals, and then the team can't even make Europa League, or it does make Europa League, can't make Champions League, is Ronaldo not that dude? Like, that's like, at what
right now they treated him like he's not.
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying. That's on the team.
It's Rashford.
Rashford
got the most goals on the team.
Yeah, but Rashford ain't getting what Ronaldo numbers that Ronaldo got last year.
No, I guarantee Ronaldo comes back and scores more if he stays.
We'll see. I don't think Ronaldo should stay, but that's
Cucurella is not it for you.
That's okay. So let me say that too. Like, I was actually, and here's another thing. Like, he's a great player. He's been doing well. But against Cucurella and against some of these other soft dudes that Saka plays against, I expect him to turn up a lot more than he has been.
So that's funny you say that, because I've been thinking the same thing all season about Saka. I just think he's saving himself for the World Cup, honestly. Honestly, because, like, I've never seen him so
reserved,
passive.
Yeah, he's just like, no, I'll give it to Martinelli or I'll give it to Odegaard. Like, they'll switch it to the left.
So I mean, like, and he gets doubled like all game.
Yes.
So that I understand.
Yeah.
But it's like, even when he's one on one, he'll still
go at these dudes. He cuts back and then
a lot
like,
of the time.
Yeah, and it's so, just like. Yeah. Yeah,
but
Cucurella was still getting sauced despite that, so he's not it. Ben Chilwell, another notable misser of the next World Cup. Like, it's making me like feel some type of way about this World Cup, even though I'm really excited. It's just kind of like, man, this having it in the middle of the year actually doesn't make sense. Doesn't make any sense. Like, these players aren't even getting a full 2 week rest ahead of the, you know, like when you end your, unless you're playing Champions League, right? Like, you end your season in early May and then you've got damn near a month to prepare for the World Cup that starts typically in June, right? Like,
bro, the chemistry with these teams not gonna be it.
Some early games are gonna be weird. Yeah.
Snorefest.
I agree with you. So we'll have to see. But yeah, Chilwell being out, Reece James being out on the right.
Reece James, that was the biggest miss.
Yeah. That was the biggest miss. Like, he, like, folks don't realize he is, in my opinion, our best player right now. Like, not always.
Yeah, for sure. No,
he's top three. And this year he's not been three. He's number one.
No, you're right.
So that's a big miss. That's a big miss for England. Folks are going to realize when Trent's playing.
Reece James plays for Chelsea is how Oliver plays for Austria everywhere.
Yeah, that's real too. That's real. Wherever you want to be, composed as you like, that's how he's going to be. So I don't know. There were some misses. Mendy doesn't seem quite himself. I'm fearing for Senegal.
The weird one, because Mendy is always like the sturdy one.
Mendy's sturdy, like, and he's relatively still, but like it's just shaky right now. It's like in that same vein of Van Dijk just coming back and just not being him anymore. You know what I mean? It's like, So I don't know, bro. Chelsea just. You could have that one. That's why I didn't bet you nothing or do nothing for that shit. But I say that, take this with a grain of salt, because come February, I'm going to be in your head, bruh. I want to know if Arsenal is going to still have this 11-1, especially after the World Cup, even though how many Arsenal players are going to the World Cup?
Not
realistically. Not that many. So maybe one. Shaka.
No. Shaka, Saka.
Saka. Shaka and Saka. Maybe any of the Brazilians? Martinelli should go. Martinelli, if Martinelli doesn't go
it'll
to the World Cup,
Jesus. But I feel on that one, it would have
Saliba.
Saliba will be a France starter,
especially with Varane.
France starter.
Kind of Thomas Partey.
Partey is gonna be playing.
Ghana.
Oh, Ghana. I was like, who's Partey?
Yeah. And that's it.
Yeah.
So five.
Yeah. None of those wing backs.
Nope.
Ben White. No.
He should go.
For
England, but for some reason. Harry Maguire has his spot fucking just on the
I mean,
lock.
It's sewn up. Like, that's Harry Maguire's Southgate's boy. They're going to live and die by...
You didn't know?
Huh?
He didn't tell you?
What?
Yeah, Maguire's part of the royal family, bro.
Oh, got it.
Maguire's always in.
I mean, but Ben White is playing right back, and he's been killing it all year. So, like, him playing at, like, a right center back would be, like, an easy slot in. So...
It would, absolutely.
Like... So this whole thing about having like Maguire is my player and he hasn't fell England yet, but he's not playing for his club at all.
He's not, but one of three. He could be one of three. It can't be Maguire, White, and who? Dyer's garbage to me. Mings should be going too. I think Mings. No?
Mings is fucking trash.
What? For his team, he doesn't really have support around him, but he's good.
Dude, yeah. Dyer had a really bad error today that led to Salah's second goal.
Dyer is trash, bro. Let me not say trash, but Dyer has mental slip-ups.
Who starts for you guys at goalie?
For England?
Yeah.
I just go Jordan Pickford, bro. Like, England don't have great keepers.
Over Aaron Ramsdale?
Yes, over Aaron Ramsdale. Yes.
Hell.
Aaron Ramsdale's not even starting for y'all.
Yeah, he is. What are you talking about?
Is he back?
He's been the starter since he got there.
Bro, all I've seen is Matt Turner for the last 6 weeks.
Nah, man, you gave him that L.
That's right.
One L. No.
That's right.
No, but he...
Wait, is Matt Turner starting in Champions League games? I've been seeing Matt Turner in every... Or Europa League games?
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Okay, that's what it is.
Yeah.
Okay. That's the only time I'm watching Arsenal, Europa League, or... Thursdays, when
George,
I have time.
I know why you're laughing, George. Like,
you're right there with him.
Yo, I'm struggling.
Europa boys over here.
But he makes... just as many saves as Pickford, and he's better with his feet than Pickford, 100%.
Yeah, but England don't play with their feet, so it don't matter.
Well, I'm saying, but like...
The fuck, you want Maguire passing the ball back to who? What?
No, but what I'm saying is Aaron Ramsdale is more equipped to handle any of that fuck shit happening.
I probably agree. In front of him. Though I think, in general, just eye test, I think Pickford is...
He's taller.
He's taller. I think, and probably is more sturdy.
Yeah.
Definitely Ramsdale's more sturdy, even though I think they're both head cases. Yeah. I think Ramsdale and Jordan Pickford are just nuts.
Yeah.
But I think Pickford is a great shot stopper.
Yeah, definitely. I agree.
I think his craziness has to do with that.
I agree.
I think Ramsdale, though better with his feet, because he's kind of not that sturdy up here, will do some fuck shit and pass the ball to a striker ready to score.
So Aaron, I will say, Aaron Ramsdale is a wild boy.
Yes.
100% of the time. But he's doing it for the betterment of the offense, which is different for a goalie. He'll try things and do things.
Yeah, to release pressure.
Whereas Pickford is like the more like, you know, I'm a goalkeeper.
I'm a shot stopper.
I'm going to just kick it out here. I'm going to pass to you there. Yeah. Aaron's doing Cruyffs. He's doing little flicks to himself. And
So because of that, it's definitely going to be Pickford starting. Because that's not what Southgate wants on in his back line. You fucking kidding? This nigga's talking about Cruyffs?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's
play the British way, bro.
The British way will get England knocked out in this first round.
And that's okay. So can we get back to the bet at hand, bro? Because the real bet is who's coming out of the group. And I'm gonna put mine down. We can bet a jersey. We can bet money, whatever you want. But I'm telling you, it's gonna be USA.
See, and who else? No, exactly.
Bro, I don't care what anybody says. It's not gonna be USA Wales. I can't do
it. I see Wales like skating by on like three draws.
So are we?
Like, I can see that.
Some wild shit.
So, is it us versus you now?
Bro, I'm doing individual bets. If you want to bet me something, I'm gonna put it out there, and you take that bet. If you don't think England and USA are getting out of the group, come bet me right now. You think it's Wales, but you got to give me who you think. You can't just say
it's Wales.
So it's Wales, USA. You hear it here. You want any of this
USA?
Sauce? Wales, USA. That's it's not that crazy though. So it's a pretty good bet to have.
What's the schedule for that group?
It's England play Wales first. I'm sorry, no, US plays Wales first.
Yeah.
Then they play England, and then they play Iran last. That's the game I'm going to. Which will be probably a pivotal game. And so if that's the case, I think Iran play England first, and then they play Wales and then US.
I think it's going to be England and US that get out.
Okay.
For sure.
All right.
For sure.
You want to go ahead and get your own bet going with Jared? You want to go ahead and look at him? He's like,
I'm ready.
I mean,
for sure.
You see,
George, you realize if you lose this bet,
you saw how much Bill was chilling, right?
Bill was chilling. He's ready for this.
All Bill needs is a free kick. So thank you.
Look at him just convincing himself. Okay, yeah,
no,
I like it.
Yeah, no,
I like it. We got something going.
It's gonna be a Harry Kane party.
Harry freaking Kane.
For sure, because he's going to be a lot more free than he's on Tottenham.
You need Sterling.
Again, when you play with 17 defenders still can't figure it out.
Sterling. No. I mean, so he's playing center back pretty much for Tottenham, but he still has 11 goals this season. So, I mean, he's still scoring.
Who, Harry Kane?
Yeah.
He's playing center back
right now.
See, but that works in a Conte side. Like, Conte's side is actually a counterattack. Gareth Southgate is not playing counterattack. He is literally playing with seven defenders and just hoping it works.
Do you start Sterling over Sancho?
Yes.
Sancho's
what?
Not even going to
what?
The World Cup, bro.
Sancho shouldn't go to the World Cup at this
at
rate.
All.
I agree.
Fuck out of here. No, I mean, my top three.
Or was it Grealish out there?
Yeah, I wouldn't start Grealish.
He can
definitely come on the bus.
Or Foden.
Foden's got to start, unfortunately.
Where?
It would probably be in that in like a cam position.
Where Mason plays?
Damn.
You set him up for that.
That's real though. So Foden might start over Sterling, honestly, just on favorability.
I would.
Sterling is starting.
It really should be Sterling and Saka.
For sure.
Mount is not going to start.
Mount's got to start, bro. Mount is the best England midfielder in the world right now. No, he's better. He and Jude play different positions, bro.
Jude, right. Yeah. Jude.
Cut it out.
Jude's definitely starting over Sterling.
Bellingham is the best.
He is the best, but he don't play the same position as Mount, so that's fine. But here's my question, because I said this to them last week: would you start Jude over Calvin Phillips? Who would you start if you had three in the middle?
What?
Exactly.
That's not a question.
No. So my
they don't play the same position.
Southgate's lineup, they do. Yeah. You got two defensive midfielders, five center backs, and goddamn,
you're right. So my ideal England team, if England had a better coach than Southgate, it would be Declan Rice at the anchor.
I forgot about
Jude Declan Rice. And Phil Foden.
Yeah,
that's trouble.
Wait,
like that's crazy.
And no Mace. What does Phil Foden give you from the middle? He can't shoot from anywhere except for inside the box. He can shoot. Let me not trip. But he can't shoot like Mason. He doesn't have the industry work rate in the middle as Mason. I don't ever want to hear nothing about Foden over Mason. Foden is a forward. He needs to be competing against Sterling, Saka.
No way.
Rashford, whoever else will be up in those positions. He's not going to compete in the middle of the park. No way.
No. So it's funny because I read an article where KDB said that he thinks once Foden gets like his man body and his man strength up, he's playing in the middle
with him
just period and picks up the same thing. And I see it as like, if he's out there with Jude and Declan Rice, it's just like that whole midfield just controls the game by themselves easily. And then you have the Saka and the Raheem, and then Kane can just float and do his little Kane shit.
Dog,
you think Saka starts?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
What do you mean? Yeah. Hell yes.
There's not one person coming off the right that's more influential than Saka in this team.
But no one's starting.
Kind of contrary to your point, or to your point, but against your point at the same time. England have had great after great midfielders or good-looking midfielders forever, yeah, and have never controlled nobody's midfield. I don't think I've ever seen a game where I'm like, damn. Even during the Golden Boy years, where you had literally Lampard, Gerard, everybody, Scholes, they were not controlling midfields. They were getting
that's
worked.
True, but those players were playing in the league that's not this league anymore. So these players are playing in leagues where like you have to be technical and know all that shit.
Yeah,
now like in that league, it was long balls and getting stuck in. That was it.
Perfect for Henderson. Henderson's gonna start. Mark my words. It's gonna be Hendo, Jude Bellingham, and then
If
Mason
he starts,
running.
it's Wales and USA for sure.
You're saying Henderson goes to the World Cup.
Yeah, Henderson for sure goes to the World Cup. Just
over,
off of GP.
Over Declan Rice.
Not over Declan Rice. It's
going
to be
Calvin Phillips is going.
Yeah, Declan, Calvin Phillips. He's not
Harry
hurt.
Kane's going and he's hurt and I've been playing for days. Yeah. Calvin's going for sure.
Calvin's going, even though Calvin has been hurt. So you need Hendo as not only a back. I think James Milner might even wind up on the roster.
Don't put James Milner in that list of 25 or however many people are on that squad. That's crazy.
It could happen, but definitely Hendo's going. Just off GP. He's a captain. He's been. You know, he's been everything.
There's no one else playing that midfield.
There are no other midfielder. There would have been Musiala, but, you know, niggas didn't treat him right in England, so he had to turn German one time. Yeah, he's smart. He's smart because Germany is a sleeper in my head. And we had Cam on the show last week, and it's like, actually, Germany is not a sleeper. Germany is a favorite. They're probably top five favorites, but they just don't even look good. And
I wouldn't say they're a favorite,
run.
Though.
Dog, name a weak spot on Germany's team.
Striker.
Sané's got that sewn up. He's been playing striker all year for a German team that has been balling. Like,
nah,
it's tough to
strike. You need scoring.
Not to mention Timo Werner is now out of the World Cup.
He's
that's another
Cup.
Notable miss.
He's out of the World Cup.
Yeah, George, Timo.
Nah, because Havertz turns into like Klose,
bro,
with Germany,
100%, or Müller at very least.
No, that's true.
Like,
out of nowhere,
it's
Havertz
just like
looks like a different
one
player,
of the most important players.
That's true.
I agree with that too.
You ain't wrong.
Well, let me switch gears real quick. We have to. It's worth note. Your boy Gerard Pique retired from football just this past weekend.
Oh my God.
Where does Gerard Pique land in the list of legendary defenders?
Legendary.
For Barcelona?
For Barcelona. We'll start with Barcelona and then we'll go to Spain.
The Man U, because he never played.
And we're not going to say nothing but Man U. Well, let me just say this, just straight off, and it's so funny because I can already see by y'all's facial expressions, but is Gerard Pique a legend? No. A soccer legend?
Yeah.
Period.
For sure.
Facts.
Okay.
Yes. Facts.
I have a question for you.
Starter for World Cup,
for the
2 Euros, and how many Champions League?
World Cup, 2 Euros, 3
titles?
Champions League.
3 titles?
I have a question for you.
Yeah.
If you're part of a team that wins.
Listen, I agree with you.
But you
already.
Don't necessarily add anything to it.
Again, I know where
you're
headed.
Are you automatically considered a legend because
yes,
you're on
if you,
the team?
If you started.
So that means
started.
So Mariano's a legend.
No, because Mariano never started.
On Real Madrid.
Mariano never started. Pique started all of those games.
He did.
Played
and
every single
all,
one.
Every,
90
majority,
minutes.
I guarantee you, majority of goals that were scored came from him.
I'm sure they did, but the man was starting. They couldn't find another. You got Mariano on the bench at Madrid. You got other people. You don't think they could have found another defender in Barcelona for how many? A decade? That man literally a decade at Barcelona as the starter. Next to Puyol.
Puyol saved him. Mascherano saved this man. Ramos saved this man.
Yeah, but he saved Puyol one time too.
Wait. But,
you remember
but,
when Puyol was put on skates by Di Maria?
Yeah, but that was his last game.
Yeah, but what you can say and all that, he was there for all
he was
of
there
it.
For all of it.
And for
which speaks
all
to something.
Of them and all of that. So
and all the trophies. And he lifted them up.
I just think it's funny.
He's worn the captain armband.
The only time this man was worth something is when Shakira was in his life.
And Messi. Yo.
This man divorced Shakira.
And Messi, you're right.
Yo, bye. We don't need
So Matt knows, and he put it on the gram, my sound bite, where I said said that Pique was trash. And this is like
in 2017.
Yeah. So like, I'm with you. I'm totally with you there. But he did start for all those teams, and he did play in all those games, in all those finals, and win all those trophies. Like,
why do you think he retired in mid season?
He's trash.
Without notice.
Without notice? He's trash. He's not good. He's like, not good. Bro, like.
But he's not been good to Jared's point, for years. We've all seen it. So why now?
Shakira done, no.
Shakira.
Because you aren't starting over anybody anymore.
Yeah, he has been on the bench. That is true.
So there's that, but also there's the whole like Barcelona owe me money type stuff. Mm. Trying to push me out. Like, it doesn't feel the same.
Bro, he's not good.
You know, all my friends aren't here anymore. Like, it's just him and Busquets.
Yeah.
Or it was just him and Busquets.
Busquets is an actual legend.
But he was playing with Barcelona with
literally Busquets and Piqué are the same person.
No, they're
technically
not. That's not true.
Busquets just passes the eye test. I'm talking about influence on a team. How many goals was Busquets letting in or giving while Messi, MSN were getting Champions League wins for them and stuff? It's all the same. These guys are legends who are fixtures in the team, who are working in the center of the park for this team. You know?
That's why your whole take on Toni Kroos is trash to me. Because you're like, oh, it's Toni Kroos. Like, he was playing all them games.
Bro, my only take on Toni Kroos is really a subjective take that he is. I've never said Toni is trash. I've only said he is the least important player.
That's not true.
You see, it sounds crazy.
That's not true.
It sounds crazy now, dude, doesn't it?
He's the least interesting player and least important starter on Madrid. Wild,
and that's all not true.
But Toni Kroos is Kroos is crazy. A legend. Like, held Germany down.
Be able to go off and do for what
sure.
he does.
If for sure. For and it's just, again, like thinking about how midfields play, like Toni Kroos under serious pressure, you don't see him misplace a pass.
Ever.
Like Ever. Very often.
He's he's always cool and calm on the ball and right. always there for the ball at any time of the game.
Yes. But always. I do. Yeah. But I mean, yeah, absolutely.
So
he's been there. But is he as important as Modric is to me on Madrid? No.
Yeah.
Is he important as Benzema, as Ronaldo, as Carvajal? Like, not really.
That's blasphemy to put Carvajal in with him.
Who? Wait, why? Carvajal got 5 Champions Leagues too.
Right, but
I mean, Toni Kroos got 6. But you know, whatever. Like, you go to Bayern,
and a World Cup too, right?
And a World Cup, sure. So, like, off Ozil's back, whatever. Bro, it's fine.
Off Ozil's back,
man. That was Ozil Pique. World Cup. I don't want to hear nothing.
Pique is not a legend. I'm sorry.
He's a
give me your top 5 Spanish. I can't even name 5 Spanish center backs. So that gives you one right there.
Hierro, Puyol, Ramos, and Zubrega Sticky for me. I even
dum bum bum. Exactly. I mean,
that's 3
household names, my niggas.
That's 3
household names. Pique is a household name. So if that's 3, he's top 4. Gotta be, right? That's all I'm saying. Now name center backs all time.
He's not there.
He gotta be top 10.
Over
Maldini.
I don't know. Like, Maldini, I still give left back.
Cannavaro,
but Cannavaro, Ramos,
Nesta,
Silva, Lucio.
Cordoba.
Who?
Ivan Cordoba.
Cordoba? No way.
Bro. Come on, bro.
No.
Maybe. If you had said Carvalho, maybe.
He's better than Pique.
I don't know, bro. Pique's got more than him. Like,
what I think you're not really seeing is, so he was there and he Real was playing, British. But there's...
Real there's, Vintage, we definitely
yeah,
missed.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah.
Terry.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're to
yeah. Okay. I'll get... I'll yeah. take that. Not top 10 of all time, for sure.
Barresi, but it's
we can keep digress.
Yeah,
we can
yeah,
keep
we can go. But yeah, so Pique is no Sergio Ramos.
No.
Because with Sergio, it's like you see his imprint on the game.
Everywhere. Yeah.
Scoring as well.
Yeah.
Like in big games
Clutch.
As well.
For sure. Clutch.
So in that sense, he's not that legendary. but he is legendary still for Barcelona, and he's definitely
I mean,
because again, he has World Cup and 2 Euros. Then he was there for all that and started all those games and played in all those games with Ramos, but he was still there.
It's a Portuguese in me. I don't want to admit it.
I appreciate you being big enough to at least say that. Like it's just within, or it's a sport. It's all subjective to a certain extent, but you know, it's going to be, it's a different world without Pique, and it's probably a better world for Barca realistically, but it's a different world for sure.
Right now,
we didn't name one French center back, and that's like blasphemy.
Oh yeah. Desailly, Laurent Blanc,
even Thuram, like
Thuram.
Like
that's what I'm saying. He's not even 20.
It doesn't matter. He's a legend. He's a Barca legend. It works out.
Well, Thuram was a right back, but yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm Maldini-ing to Thuram a little bit. But, I mean, yeah, there's been great center backs for sure. But Pique, in his own right, deserves a little something. So happy retirement, Pique.
Happy retirement.
We've been calling you garbage for so many years. Maybe we'll actually...
It's time.
Maybe we'll actually respect you a little bit more, and I hope that things work out, you know, with or without Shakira. That's all I have to say about that. A couple questions for you. One more topic I want to talk about. I saw recently, and I haven't really looked into it further than this last week of games in Germany. There were banners thrown up saying boycott 2020 World Cup Qatar, which, you know, clearly means that they're not happy with the. I mean, there's a lot going on in Qatar, but you know, just
we've
the
been
Middle
known
East.
That, though.
I mean,
like we've been known all this, and then all of it's,
exactly.
It's now it's like,
does
oh.
it mean does it mean anything to you?
No.
Why Germany?
No.
Yeah.
Germany. They have to, honestly. Like,
yeah.
They can't drink.
That's what it is. Oh, no beer fest in the.
Like you gotta understand, alcohol is a big deal in these tournaments.
Yeah. Well,
so they did allow beer, but they have like a drunk tank zone where you have to stay
in the hotel or something.
It's in the hotels.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be drinking. Believe me. Again, you'll be seeing it. We're gonna be broadcasting live. I will keep it real with y'all, whether or not we can drink. But I'm gonna be drinking.
Just be careful out there. Son.
I'm not gonna be on no substances, narcotics, and I'm gonna be drinking where they designate. But I'm gonna be drinking.
You see Matt on fucking yo, on the fucking History Channel.
Fuck us all. Yo, like nah, son. We told him not to do it.
You see George on fucking CNN. Like, yeah, man. Like, I was trying to tell him, no,
free
but...
Free MM, you know, MM shirts.
I got you, bro.
Yo.
Damn. That'd be crazy. I mean... Now, based on your France trip, I mean...
Yeah, exactly.
You might need to simmer down with all that.
I'm going
to
simmer down. We're not droning. that fuckery. Chilling. Maybe it's good I lost my drone recently. Like, we were talking about this LAFC game. I really like this LAFC stadium. Seats 2,200 people. I'm in the nosebleeds, and it's not a bad seat
at all.
Watching a game, a World Cup final, whatever. What seat would you prefer to have? I'll give you 4 options. Would you prefer to be first row, field level, but behind the goal? Would you prefer to be nosebleeds, but dead center of the field, seeing everything? Would you prefer to be in the section 200, so somewhere in between, at the corner flag, or would you prefer to be in a box seat?
Where's the box seat, though?
I mean, box seats are typically midfield, mid-level, right? Like, so middle, but you're not with really any fans. You're in your own area eating and drinking your own food. And let's just say you don't have nobody with you, so you're alone in the box seat. Let me just add that. Would you prefer to have boxes... but you're all alone for one of the greatest games?
I'd say that I'd be in the 200 level just so I can be like feel the crowd.
Mm.
And you can still see the field.
Corner flag's not a bad. At least you see one side. You see goals on one side.
Yeah, but you see it on one side though.
Yeah, that's been my issue. I'm always a middle person. Yeah. Like movie theaters or anything.
Yeah.
Like I want to sit in the middle, in the center. You saying box? My man George Bushy as hell. He said he literally mouthed box.
Box.
I don't care if I'm alone. I don't care if the chicken wings are too hot.
Nah, because then I'm in the if I'm fire. In the box, I could go to the field after.
That is true. You can go field level with the box,
sometimes.
But I didn't add that. I didn't. Yeah, exactly. Sometimes, but that's not. I'm talking about just watching a game. Where would you prefer to watch it? Would you prefer to watch a game again? Like
I'm watching it in the box. Don't try to explain nothing. I'm staying
about to watch.
That's fair enough.
I'm staying.
That's fair. That's fair. Okay, so we got middle row. I'd like to be field.
I don't have people waving flags blocking my view. Yo,
that is tough.
Dale. Go. Oh my god.
Dale, black and go. Yeah, that's our next order of business is working on chants.
Any fan from LAFC, y'all need to create like 3 or 4 more chants.
I'm gonna bring some new chants to the team, bro.
Because when I'm hearing Dale, black and gold for an hour straight,
love it. Like, love it.
And you gotta go to the left.
You a Galaxy fan, ain't you?
That's funny. I don't know what I am.
Yeah,
I'm
an LAFC fan. I felt the energy you felt when a team who actually was playing in LA came to LA.
For sure.
Even though you're a Long Beach boy, so actually Galaxy is not.
It's right there.
Not too far away. It's right
like
there.
5 miles, 10 miles away.
But yeah.
Yeah.
I asked this question. I'm going to start asking this on every podcast. Would you rather watch a football match or play in one? Let me rephrase this so it makes a lot more sense. Would you rather be in your favorite seat that you just picked out at a World Cup final or play in an NCAA national championship game?
Play.
It's so easy, dog.
100%.
I need to get non-players on here. That's what it is. I 100%. Need to get people who actually don't play but still love the sport to really speak to it, because good question. Okay. Last question of the day. This is for all of you. The greatest Brazilian of all time. In your opinions. I'm not saying it's not a healthy debate. I just want to know, if you were to pick one Brazilian for your world team, what Brazilian are you picking?
Pele or Zico?
I'm picking Ronaldinho, dog.
Ooh.
Off rip. Off rip, Ronaldinho. Prime Dino is washing Pele at any time. I'm sorry.
It might have been Pele for me, but I think I'm actually, because I rephrase it for myself in this way, if I had a World 11, I could pick any Brazilian in their prime. It would be between Neymar and R9. It would probably be R9, though. Phenomeno. It would definitely be Phenomeno. Ronaldinho, great player. You want to tell him about my hot take last week?
You tell him.
I mean, now that he said this, it's just going to be an argument. But I told my man that I'm taking. I just know this is going to, you're just going to roll your eyes. I'm taking Neymar over prime Ronaldinho. No, I'm sorry. This is not what I said. Skill set. If you were to be given Space Jam, somebody handed you the phone, you got it. Whose skills are you taking?
Ronaldinho.
Everybody's entitled to your own opinion, but Neymar,
I've been bugging for 2 weeks.
Yo.
Don't worry.
Yo. Hot takes. We're going to the World Cup. Maybe I'm excited.
That was just foolishness.
Maybe it's
week.
Fever.
No, this week is.
What foolishness?
Who was who?
It was that was his foolish.
Oh, that no. There were two things today they said that were just blasphemy.
Bro, Hendo?
Who was it?
And
No, it was Hendo versus
and then Chicharito, the guy on LAFC.
No, Chicharito Arango is a player. Don't.
No. You said that you rather have Hendo than somebody, and that was crazy to me.
Oh yeah, Jorginho.
Oh yeah, that's great. Yeah, it was. No.
Yeah, Jorginho. Jorginho, not Genie.
Yeah.
I said Jorginho. No,
that was crazy.
I would still rather have Hendo than Jorginho.
That's crazy. But then I would take Dino's skill set over Neymar's 100% of the time. 100% of the time.
We'll talk a little bit more about why, but it's
at their primes, who peaked the highest?
I mean, I'm talking skill sets. So again, even and peak.
Well,
at their primes.
Still, at their primes, there's still skill set.
Yeah. Okay.
There's a peak skill set.
Yeah.
Whose is better?
It's kind of closer than you think, right? Because one has longevity in peaks, and one got a Ballon d'Or. You know, so one had a great two years.
No, he had
the
greatest
of all time.
He had a great, like 3.5-4 years where it was that was him. That was him.
3.5-4 is real. Yeah. Is a real stretch.
No.
3.5-4 was his whole career. Barcelona. Like,
no, he was still balling.
At PSG.
Milan is Milan, bro.
His last year at PSG was balling. Barcelona, the first 3 years balling.
Yeah, no, I remember. It was Seedorf, Pirlo.
He was kind of washed by then.
Beckham. Yeah, he was washed. I mean, he played great because he plays great. But I'm saying, like, even like, in this Farmers League that Neymar is playing in,
yeah,
he's playing at the absolute highest. He's playing in higher levels than Ronaldinho
against
was.
Nantes and shit.
But he's playing in the Champions League. Ronaldinho wasn't even playing high comp in the Champions League. Milan was out early every year.
Yeah, but he beat Arsenal Champions League, unfortunately.
What does that mean?
He won.
This World Cup is going to answer this question.
This World Cup is going to answer all your questions about Neymar. I'm telling you right now.
Yeah, it's make a break. Are you that dude or were you just
a flashy dude? I'm telling you right now, even though France is the team I support and I kind of really want to see a
Saliba.
Okay. Arsenal needs some new chance too, by the way.
Facts. You're right. 100%.
But I'm telling you right now, it's either Messi, Neymar, or Mbappe's year, and I would love it to be Neymar or Mbappe. I could care less about Messi. But whoever's winning this World Cup, I need PSG. I need it to be a PSG player, and I need it to carry on into the Champions League because I can't wait.
Is Sergio balling right now for PSG?
He is balling right now for PSG. So, Sergio's back. That's PSG is clicking now, like legit.
Yeah.
So
with Sergio back, that changes their back line. It changes a lot. He can
affect a game. He can get on both sides, both ends of the field. He can also get you a red card and just tear some shit up.
That's true.
So we'll see. More to come, boy, but I appreciate having you back.
Yes, sir.
We got the World Cup coming up soon. More episode to go until you seeing me live in Qatar. We got more to come. It's E-Pray Ball. We'll see you next time.
Yes, sir.